then colonial nation of southern Rhodesia, now known as Zimbabwe, that was named after a railway man the imperialist Cecil John Rhodes, had the railway system as the key enabler of the colonial economy. This imperialist had the vision of a Cape to Cairo railway and began to put his dream into effect. Although the railway as he planned it does not exist in its entirety, Rhodesia was developed mainly by this means. Even after independence, the new Zimbabwe faced a threat of economic warfare through the railways from apartheid South Africa.
So at any time, they can strangle us. I can give an example. When the 10 round of trains between us and South Africa was once at 13 days, and then they increased it to 18 days. They increased to 40 days. But after some discussions with them, they have now reduced down to 18 to 20 days. But under Smith, it was 13. So you can see that it is necessary for us to move away from that situation where, by the stroke of a pen, they can lengthen the 10 round of trains.
Due to the genesis of the initial war of liberation known as the First Chimurenga Umvukela, as well as an epidemic of rinderpest that had broken out in Rhodesia, killing the Keko and stopping all forms of animal drawn transport, Rhodes decided that the railway must be built as rapidly as possible. He gave orders that the rails must reach Bulawayo before the end of 1897. When the first iron horse entered into Rhodesia, it signaled the creation of a colonial empire that would oppress the people of Zimbabwe for a century. From that day on, the Rhodesia Railways was a key cog in the whole colonization strategy, as it was a vital link for transportation and communication. However, as the struggle for liberation intensified, the Rhodesia Railways was a natural strategic military target for our freedom fighters. During the course of the War of Liberation, our armed liberation forces carried out various attacks on the railway system. One such memorable attack was on locomotive 411, which was bombed to oblivion by the then young Emmerson Mnangagwa. Now the same Emmerson Mnangagwa is the president of Zimbabwe. On one memorable Friday afternoon, President Mnangagwa took some time off his busy schedule to visit the Railways Museum in Bulawayo and have a look at some of the remnants of the walls on steel that enabled colonization. On his arrival, His Excellency President Idi Mnangagwa was shown the President Idi Mnangagwa Safari Leisure Diner.
What is this mystery? Don't just put my name there.
This diner has been preserved to remain luxurious even after 100 years. After the Idi Mnangagwa coach, the president was taken on a brief tour of the museum by the curator, Mr. Murray.
This engine here was built in 1903 and it did over 1.1 million miles. When this engine originally came to this country, it was wood burning, as your first coal train for Wangen was the 1st of December 1903. And this engine here is a shunt engine built in 1929, only used in and around a railway station from moving wagons from point A to point B.
In the Cecil John Rhodes coach, President Mnangagwa went through various artifacts that included memoirs, poems, and even cutlery.
This is Cecil John Rhodes' coach, built in 1896 by Pullman and Company, and it was the same coach that brought his body back in 1902 for burial in the Matopus. His coffin was there, in the room there.
Mm-hmm.
That bunk can fold down, all right, and somebody can sleep on it, you can sleep on that. This coach has both electric and paraffin lamps. And this is a photograph of his coffin in here, when they took his body off in Bulawayo and his grave in Matopo. The bed actually folded out the wall this way for him to sleep on. But when they brought his body back, the troops needed room, so they took his bed out. It's in Cape Town Museum. When you come through here, okay? Yes. When you come through here, that's his toilet, hand basin, and bath. It's in there. This is an old type ticket office where they used to sell the tickets when you wanted to board the train and travel to various destinations in Zimbabwe. The plates, the cups, and the teapot from here were, in 1947, were used on the train when King George VI came out here. All right. Last year, this was some of the stuff that was used on the railways, and that's a model of Harare Station. This here is a centralized train control panel, which shows you where all the trains are all of the time. We were the first country in Africa to have that system, okay? Then the last one is this one here. This was St. John's, the ambulance people. The chapter here in Zimbabwe was started by railwaymen in 1926. This engine is called Jaktar. It was built in 1889. And this engine helped build Victoria Falls Bridge. And it was the first to cross the bridge. When they built the bridge was built from either side, what was then Northern Rhodesia and Southern Rhodesia, and it met in the middle on the 1st of April, 1905, and the bridge was commissioned on the 12th of September, 1905. Now, Jaktar, we did a little bit of homework, and the only thing we can come across is the British sailors, when they went out on their sailing ships long ago, used to put tar in their hair, and they were called Jaktars.
After the tour, the president gave a brief and impromptu keynote address.
I was here last week. In my discussion with those I was with, some of them are here. Among many issues that we discussed, we were discussing some historical issues. And among the historical issues we discussed, we tumbled on the name Cecil John Rhodes. In the process, I was educated that when he died in Cape Town, he was brought here in a private coach which was dedicated to him during his lifetime. The one he used to travel between Rhodesia, North and South, and South Africa. That was the VIP coach Cecil John Rhodes was using. So I wanted to know where the coach was. And I was told that the coach was here in Bulawayo. Then I said, I wanted to go in the seat. Well, but at the end of the day, I'm happy that what I wanted to know, I now know. What I wanted to see, I have now seen. I needed to come here. I wanted to understand the spirit, the environment that existed in 1896, 93 to 96, when Rhodes was commuting between Cape Town and Southern Rhodesia, and the coach he was using, the facilities he had created himself for himself and some of his colleagues, the four musketeers he used to move around with. Beyond that, I was also told that there was a coach here at the Bulawayo Railway Museum, which was dedicated to King George VI of the United Kingdom, the father to the queen, current queen. And the coach is here, but they put sanctions on us. So I've been shown the coach which King George VI used to come here and they use with the King George family, including Queen Elizabeth when she was a young, beautiful girl. The pictures are here. The utensils they used for dinner, for lunch, and for breakfast, all those things are here. We have looked after these things, I think, for nearly 100 years now, or thereabout. That history has been preserved. One would expect that there should be excellent relations between us and those who came after King George VI. And now, I've also seen a replica of the locomotive which me and my colleague, the late Matthew, blew up. The picture is here, and a replica has been assembled here. That I didn't know. What I cannot say, which is in my mind, is that I have certain things which I want to do, but I only do them after I've discovered precisely what happened during that time. So that every aspect of history must be in its correct place. That having been said, I will elaborate on another day when I will implement what I have in mind. Because from what I have seen today, a few things which we current generation know are not correct. They need to be corrected, and correct history preserved. Not conveniently preserved, but accurately preserved. But I believe that I need another occasion when actually I'll be ready to unfold and unpack what is necessary to be done so that generations to come will access correct history about the past and about our country and about our heroes who are gone before us. But for today, I'm happy that I've been able to see the coach which was used to colonize us. I thank you.
With the coach that was used to colonize us, our history remains intertwined with that of our former oppressors. As we move forward to consolidate our heritage, it is imperative that we redefine our history, for our history defines our heritage. To keep the memory of Buto, His Excellency President Edi Mnangagwa commissioned the Railways Museum as a National Tourism Development Site.